Warning. The Surgeon General has determined that the sounds you are about to hear will always be devastating to your ears.
Sleep well. Is it a doll or is it a baby?
I love Madrip. He makes me match. Joy, my favorite. My nigga, Madrip. Obrigado.
You are listening to the Lance J Radio Network.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Apparently Georgia. See, I've been talking all day, so we're talking a lot of sports on a Monday on Lance J Radio Network. I got a lot of healthcare stuff coming in on the back end of the week. Got some good interviews. Trying to connect with Dr. Fabian Garcia. See how things are going down in Orlando following the hurricane. But we're pretty much all sports today. The media decides. It's. I remember if the name was correct. This was a game many years ago when the Tampa Bay Buccaneers were coming up through the ranks, and I'm not talking about the Brady Buccaneers. I'm talking about the Tony Dungy / John Gruden Buccaneers when Warren Sapp was antagonizing people, and you had John Lynch, and you had Rondé Barber, and you had all of these guys that would be Hall of Famers on the Tampa Bay Buccaneers defense. But they had bad quarterback play. I think they had Sean King was their quarterback. This guy number 10 was a little guy. And their defense was only giving up like 10 points. But they were winning games 12-10 because they couldn't score. And they played the Pittsburgh Steelers, and Lee Flowers, I believe, was a starting cornerback. The Steelers beat the brakes off of the Buccaneers, and he referred to them as the, quote, paper champions. And that was something that the Bucs took a lot of offense to, that because when they won the Super Bowl a couple of years later, Warren Sapp brought it up in the press conference. And he said, Lee Flowers, you called us the paper champions. We are the world champions now. And the media comes up with these paper champions, and Georgia is the media's paper champion. The media has decided that Georgia and Alabama are the best teams in college football. Doesn't matter what their resume is. Doesn't matter how they play. Doesn't matter week to week. Other people are held to a standard. If Ohio State, and I'm not being an Ohio State homer in this particular case, I'm just looking at the games. Michigan, who I hate, who I detest, they go into Iowa. They had a very methodical, physical win over the weekend. That gets a lot of respect for me. Kinnick Stadium is not an easy place to play. But the media has decided that Georgia and Alabama are just a cut above everybody else, even though that doesn't always reflect the play on the field. Now, when Georgia was boat racing Oregon, they looked like the best team in the country, and I think week to week, you have teams that look really good. There's a lot of parity in college football this year. You have Alabama and Georgia and Ohio State, which many of us feel have better rosters, more depth based on the allocation of stars, the rivals.com view. But me personally, I think that Utah is a good team. As people are sleeping on Utah because they lost at Florida. That's a difficult game to fly across country, go to the swamp. You're not playing against anyone in the Pac-12 like Florida at the swamp. And it was a close game. They lost. I can see Utah running the table. I can see Utah winning the national title. They gave Ohio State everything they wanted last year in the Rose Bowl. And if you didn't have Jackson Smith and Chigba catching 350 yards, they were on the way to thrashing Ohio State. And in Columbus, 3 losses, you're on the hot seat, Ryan Day. But the media, like I said, has decided. So Georgia, I watched the entire game, Georgia at Missouri. And Missouri may play in the SEC, but Missouri is not an SEC team. Let me repeat that. Missouri may play in the SEC, but Missouri is not an SEC team. Missouri does not have SEC speed. Missouri does not have SEC coaching. Missouri does not have SEC athleticism. Missouri does not have SEC cheerleaders. Missouri does not have SEC boosters. Missouri does not have SEC NIL. Missouri does not have SEC recruiting ground. Missouri does not have SEC uniforms. Missouri does not have SEC endowment. Missouri does not have SEC recruiting budget. And Stetson Bennett, who's 5'11", 180 pounds, looked like a guy that was 5'11", 180 pounds. I don't see anything in Stetson Bennett that says to me that he can take a team to the promised land. Now, if Georgia mauls you on defense, which they have all of that great talent, they got the tight end, I can't remember his name, number 0, that's hurdling people. He's 6'7", 275 pounds. That's like when you create yourself on Madden or NCAA football, which I think is coming out next year. I can't wait for that. I'm not a gamer, but I'll be back on the sticks. I will be playing that all the time. My wife will be very disgusted with me if they bring back NCAA. But if all of Georgia's talent on the perimeter and on defense mauls you and causes turnovers and 3 and outs, then yeah, they're when you're getting 6 extra possessions because they're 3 or 4 turnovers and the other team's going 3 and outs. So if you're getting 14 possessions instead of 9 possessions, then Georgia's gonna work you. But we've seen, I thought that it was a little bit of a red flag. I gave them benefit of the doubt with Kent State. Kent State playing that game at home, you're bored. You're just saying that this is boring. This is beneath us. But going on the road, and that's why I'm not going to wave the Ohio State flag. They play all their games at home. They got to go to Michigan State, who isn't any good. But once again, do they go to Michigan State, who isn't any good, and beat them by 30, or do they go to Michigan State and beat them by 7? They got to play Penn State on the road in a couple weeks. Penn State is good. Ohio State's better. But playing these games on the road kind of separates the wheat from the tare. I'm just saying, I watched that game with Georgia. I was very unimpressed with their quarterback, Stetson Bennett. Missouri's not a very good team. Even playing at Missouri, that's not like playing at Tennessee. Even at Kentucky, Missouri is the bottom of the SEC next to Vanderbilt. So we'll just have to see. I mean, I'm not going to bash Georgia. They won the game. I think when you have these tough games, you win the game. If you win the game, that's winning by 6 is not losing. But when Ohio State doesn't beat Notre Dame as bad as expected, well, it's Ohio State's not that good. We immediately downgrade a Big Ten team or a non-SEC team if they don't do what they're supposed to do. But Georgia has played, now they fell to 2nd in the poll. Alabama's 1st in the poll. But we're just going to ignore that Texas game. Texas isn't elite. And I just think Bama and Georgia, you see these guys on the road, I don't think that either of these teams are infallible. And I'm fine if just by reputation you want to put them, but who's to say that Alabama and Georgia, I'm not sold that they're better than Ohio State or Michigan. And you guys know I hate Ann Arbor Community College. For all I know, that Ohio State and Michigan are 2 best teams in the league. Excuse me, the I'm thinking about the NFL. They're the 2 best teams in college football. How do I know that Clemson's not better? Clemson's won close games against tough opponents. How do I know that Utah isn't better? How do I know that USC isn't better? And I just think it comes back down to that media bias with the SEC. And we know that the SEC has the best athletes, they have the best coaches, they have the best everything. And I would be a fool, I would be a fraud, I would not be a journalist if I questioned that. But week to week, year to year, we just don't know that. I don't see anything in Alabama or Georgia that tells me that they're miles away from everyone else. The best team I've seen this year is Ohio State. I'm not just saying that because I'm an Ohio State guy. I trust CJ Stroud and the Ohio State offense and Ryan Day more than I trust anything that I've seen. For now, that may change. But you know the Ohio State's offense, they're going to put up 40 pretty much every week. We'll see what happens when they play Penn State and Michigan later in the year. I don't trust Stetson Bennett at all. I can't wait till they play Tennessee. And with Alabama, I just still don't. I don't trust their back seven. And they had the running back Gibbs that broke out over the weekend, but I don't see that explosive speed. I don't see the ability to score at will like I've seen in previous years. But you know, ultimately, I'm gonna trust Nick Saban first. So if you put a gun to my head, I'm going to say that Alabama is who I trust the most. Ohio State second because they have CJ Stroud. Michigan and Jim Harbaugh running off tackle probably third. And Utah with all of that talent fourth. But, you know, I just think this concept, we have to stop saying that, hey, some teams, if Georgia doesn't play well at Missouri, that just shows how great the SEC is. No, it doesn't. It just shows that Georgia's not as good as advertised. And that they're a young team. That's a little Jekyll and Hyde. They might come back. I don't know who they play next week on their schedule. They might come back next week and win by 50. But the bias does get on my nerves.
You are listening to the Lance J Radio Network.
This is Lance J for MedHealth Clinical. When was the last time you had an annual wellness visit? MedHealth is currently accepting new patients and all major insurance carriers, including Medicare. This experienced team focuses on wellness and disease prevention while developing personalized care plans that mitigate chronic conditions and encourage holistic wellness. To learn more, go to MedHealthClinic.com. That's MedHealthClinic.com for primary care that's always there.
I'm the latest hashtag challenge, and everyone on social media is trying me. I'm trending so hard that hashtag common sense can't keep up. This is gonna get tens and tens of views. But if you don't have the right auto insurance coverage, you could be left to pay for this yourself.
Get Allstate and be better protected from mayhem for a whole lot less.
This is Lance J, a.k.a. the Paragon of Sports Talk Excellence, a.k.a. the Heisenberg of Broadcast Radio, a.k.a. the Wolf of Wall Street. The Lance J Radio Network is now on WWE 1100 a.m. weekdays from 3 to 4 p.m. I've been wanting to get into the Atlanta market for a long time. Listen to me and the rest of the ticket talk sports, politics, healthcare as DJ Rampage, the first lieutenant of the Universal Flip Mode Squad, shines on the wheels of steel playing the best in classic hip-hop. Catch the show live or download the iHeartRadio application.